In this video, I'll be explaining anatomy of pectoralis minor, also known as pec minor. I will explain the origin, insertion, and function of pec minor, then I will describe why this pec minor is very important. The first of all, I'd like to explain the origin. Origin is from rib 3-4-5. It starts from rib 3-4-5. Then insertion is here, this bony part. This part is coracoid process, which is part of scapula. So please remember, it originates from rib cage and it inserts on the scapula. This is very, very important. So next, I'd like to explain the function of pec minor. Since direction of pec minor is a little bit unique, kind of diagonal, right? This can do many movements. I will turn the skeletal model. So this is the scapula. Pec minor can do three movements. The one is depression of scapula. It's kind of pull down the scapula this way. Depression and downward rotation. Downward rotation is a rotational movement which brings this way. So scapula moves this way. This is downward rotation. Now one more movement, which is abduction of scapula. Abduction is opening up scapula. Three movements. Depression, downward rotation, and abduction of scapula. I know it's a little bit confusing. Wait, what? Abduction? How is that possible? Because pec minor pulls scapula this way. So it's kind of going this way, right? This way. Then it brings scapula outward, which is abduction. Pulls this way, makes depression, downward rotation, and abduction. Very important muscle for scapular movement than shoulder movement. Why? Because scapula and shoulder joint needs to move together. I have said this like million times in my videos. I cannot emphasize enough. Scapula, shoulder have to move together. And pec minor is crucial for shoulder movement. Why? Because the function of pec minor was downward rotation. When we move our shoulders, our scapula needs to do upward rotation. However, if pec minor gets tight, the scapula is fixed on the downward rotation position. If pec minor gets tight, what happens? We cannot move shoulder joint freely. So pec minor is so important. Flexibility of pec minor is essential, especially for any kind of sports which you use hand over head, like baseball, or like a tennis, badminton, or volleyball. Any sports over the head, move, use the shoulder, flexibility of pec minor is so, so important. And I'd like to talk about the connection with this one. You see that yellow line? This represents nerve. This yellow wire represents brachial plexus. Brachial plexus is the bundle of nerves on the neck, chest area, and this brachial plexus becomes each nerve, like axillary nerve, median nerve, ulnar nerve, radial nerve. Then these nerves go to tips of finger. So brachial plexus is like a big trunk of upper body nerves. See, this is pec minor. Attaches on rib cage and coracoid process. These nerves, brachial plexus, goes posterior to pec minor. You see, there's not much space here. It's very hard to see because it's very tiny space. Anyway, brachial plexus passes posterior to pec minor. So what if pec minor gets tight? Does this space get tight? Yes, of course. Then brachial plexus can be pinched. This symptom is called thoracic outlet syndrome. So pec minor is very important for pain around here or axillary area, maybe arm area. Pec minor tightness can be one of the causes of thoracic outlet syndrome. Thus, pec minor is important for scapula and shoulder, and also important for pain. Why? Because brachial plexus passes posterior to pec minor. I cannot emphasize enough. I personally focus on pec minor very, very often. So in this video, I explained basic anatomy of pec minor. It is freaking important for shoulder movement, scapular movement, and pain around here. So if you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.